Drink up. Cheers.
Ooh, the exalted count asks for a glass.
Hey, check by that dumbass Alberto.
That kook can't ever finish a sentence he starts. Must have a brain made of Swiss cheese.
Show some respect, Humphrey. Alberto's a genius with weapons and armor. What's your big skill? Farting into a harmonica and calling it music? Hey, you mangy pricks! And he's gonna kick your derrieres.
Said she had important business to attend to, but you can wait here with us if you came to find out if I have a boyfriend, which doesn't mean you have the slightest chance with me. Fine. What brings you? Right.
This could be a very
thing. I need that one.
Sophie. Yes, she went. She said
she went that way.
Exactly. There's more. One more thing. Something's wrong with not working with it broken. That
Dad's asking.
Can I ask you a question,
Vincenzo?
Pilgrim? Does that mean you're a murderer?
Vincenzo! Why? What do you... Why would you...
Dad, I'm asking because I'm curious.
To what end?
Vincenzo! Leave him! Alone!
Did you? I hope to succeed. I'd never found Federico. Federico. He was my best friend. We were like brothers. We'd known each other forever. He disappeared like the other. Because of those fucking... You heard that when they built the walls, they were trying to create a vaccine here? It all fell apart in a couple of weeks. One day, Federico vanished. We'd been playing football. I went to my house after that. He went home too. And I never saw him again. And that's not all. You see, he wasn't the only child who went missing that winter. From the building next door at the same time. No, but based on what Federico's mother said, I have a feeling I know what happened. Federico had been in the hospital a month earlier with pneumonia. His mother was told that some GRE doctor had tests, but they wouldn't tell her why. A week after he was released from the hospital, he was gone. GRE business. Then everything went to hell. The GRE collapsed. After that, some in the central loop. But
Working now?
I swear I'll tear them apart and eat the pieces! Bertie! Ralph! To your help! I love you!
Do you remember the beginning of the fall, Aiden? I remember it as if it were yesterday. We'd been defending the church against infected for some time. My mother was in charge. She was losing dozens of people every day. She was keeping everyone alive while I was keeping an eye on Barney. She begged the peacekeepers for help, but they ignored her. Eventually, she was injured. It was dawn. They led me to her, to the roof of the sacristy. She saw me and made me promise to look after my brother. She said it as if she was lending me a car and asking me to have it returned intact. After that, she appointed Carl as her successor, with me at his side. You'll grow up to be a far better leader than Carl, she said. But while the world is burning, people won't listen to someone so young. I've been thinking like that all my life, but not anymore. Now I understand my mother. You have to be ruthless to be a leader. I wasn't ready then. I am now. Talking about someone in particular? I'm sorry. That's why you came to town. For her. Jack and Joe will be.
Aiden. I'm watching you, Pilgrim.
The peacekeepers are watching us. I'll let them see what happens to Jack and Joe, and that we can do it to them too. We're acting. I sent 3 scouts towards the camp. Carl and the crystals must be somewhere inside the building. Not many guards. Most are probably asleep. There are a few entrances to the camp. The front one, suicide. It's got the most guards. We'll catch them in the pincer movement. If anything goes wrong, we retreat to our base.
Wish I were home in bed right now, you know.
Got an intruder over here!
Ah! Ah! kidding me?
Yeehaw! Let's go!
What the fuck is that?
Who's this?
Hang on a minute.
Jackson, fuck me! Who the hell is out there?
How could that be?
What's that?
Asshole. Wait now. Who's that waltzing back?
Check your traps.
Have this, motherfucker.
You dumb motherfucker. Look alive, asshole.
Thank you.
Pilgrim and...
Bravo, Pilgrim. Where's everyone else?
They were attacked. Where are the crystals?
Over there. Radio Sophie. Fast.
Sophie, I have a call. It's okay. What about you guys?
Sophie? You have to help the maiden. Tango Motel. Sophie's hideout is there. Run. Fast.
Someone's been... I'll pray...
is it open yet?
Like hell.
At least tell me you've been to the doctor.
I'm not going to be groped by some strange guy.
You can all.
It looks like you were getting close to the. Either they killed Lucas, or they know who did. We'll force them to talk. By taking control of the water tower. Jack and Joe took off somewhere. Only stragglers left in the tower at best. This is the only source of water in the area. And whoever controls the water, controls old Villador. It's gone, the bazaar will station guards at the tower. At the first sight of the PK, there'll be an immediate clash of forces. Charges left by Jack and Joe. Whoever's left up there. The tower's the tallest structure in the area. The only way up was cut off. All right. Go for it. If you pull it off, we'll gain massive leverage for the bazaar to tell us who the killer was. Thank you.
Just collect money.
Jack!
PK, they'll be honest in a moment. Nobody's getting out alive. You asshole. Who's there?
Pilgrim who showed up at the bazaar recently?
Maybe. Pilgrim or Pope. So?
Don't you get it? If he's a pilgrim, he can get us out. Lead us out of the city to someplace safe.
I don't trust that.
You don't trust anyone! I told you to play nice with Barney when we had the chance! Fucking listen to me for once! To make him get the fuck out of the bazaar! After what we found out from the peacekeepers.
We tipped off the fucker, gave him a chance to run. But he thought he was too clever.
Well, about Luke is wanting to take him to the weapons and set a trap for him for weeks. Instead of politely getting the fuck out of here, he tried to play cute instead.
The more he wanted, the more.
And you ask me, war's the last thing we need. Crystals? That's a different story.
That's why I tried to put an end to that rabbit dog and his sister. So, will you get us out of the city or what?
Calm down, Joe.
I won't fucking calm down.
Get us out of the city, Pilgrim. To the nearest safe settlement. And no one will die here.
Sounds like a huge risk.
He's like Jack.
There's no other way.
Fuck! I don't like it.